Welcome to A&M Awesome Animals!
Hello everyone! Today we are talking about ragdolls and we will be traveling to California. Please don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel for future weekly videos. What can be verified is that the breed was started in the 1960s in California. The ragdoll may well have been a mix of the Burmese, the Burman, and the Persian cat. But the cat credited as the original ragdoll is a white cat named Josephine. For that reason, ragdolls are also called the daughters of Josephine. Developed by an American breeder and baker in the 1960s, they are best known for their docile and placid temperament and affectionate nature. The name ragdoll is derived from the tendency of individuals from the original breeding stock to go limp and relaxed when picked up. Ragdoll cats are known to be gentle, calm, and sociable. Affectionate without being demanding, ragdolls have an almost dog-like devotion to their owners. Some people also say that attuned to emotional needs are a characteristic that makes them a perfect companion animal. Ragdolls are generally healthy, but bladder stones and a heart condition known as hyperthermic cardiomyopathy are among the conditions that have been reported the most in the breed. Hyperemic cardiomyopathy is the most common form of heart disease in cats. No one can guarantee that their cats will never develop HCM. The ragdoll is one of the largest domesticated cat breeds. With a sturdy body, large frame, and proportionate legs, a fully grown female weighs from 8 to 15 pounds. Males are substantially larger, ranging from 12 to 20 pounds. Ragdolls come in 6 different colors: red, seal, chocolate, and the corresponding dilutes, including blue, lilac, and cream. This also includes the lynx and tortoise shell variations in all colors and the 3 patterns. This isn't a surprising fact. Ragdoll eyes may come in different shapes and shades of blue. However, it is important to note that all purebreds have blue eyes. If your ragdoll has shades of green or yellow in her eyes, then she is probably a mix. I have read of some websites referring to ragdolls as having other shades to their eye color. This is not true of the breed. Some cats have personalities that are similar to a dog. Ragdolls take the best traits from dogs, such as loyalty and playfulness. They are fiercely loyal to their families and love being near their humans. Ragdolls will even wait patiently outside a door for their owner to come and play. They love to play just like any other cat. They have also been known to play a game of fetch. Ragdolls also tend to carry around their favorite toys in their teeth, trotting along like a satisfied puppy. Some are even known to excitedly greet their owners at the door, but don't expect them to bring the newspaper. This breed is generally quiet. This can be a good thing, although some people told me that they are so quiet they don't show distress or pain. Their color and pattern develop sometime between 1 to 2 weeks of age. Then the breeder is able to tell what color pattern they might be. The breeder is also able to predict what the possibilities of color pattern combos of a litter of kittens will be because of their color pattern of parents. Ragdolls are not hypoallergenic. This myth comes from their lack of an undercoat. Excessive shedding of this undercoat is what causes many of the allergies. Other allergies are caused by cat saliva, which of course will still be a factor with a ragdoll. Ann Baker, a breeder who lived in California during the 1960s, is credited with creating the ragdoll. Baker took a domestic long-haired white female that was found running around in the wild in her neighborhood and bred her with another long-haired cat. The resulting kittens were the progenitors of the ragdoll breed. By selecting 4 traits like a friendly personality and long plush fur, Baker eventually produced the big soft kitty we know and love today. One of the cats in the original ragdoll bloodline may have been Siamese-like markings. Or Baker mated that first cat with Burman, Burmese, or Persian cats. However, since nobody quite knows which breeds Baker used to create the ragdoll, the origin of the breed classic's color pointed coat, that its points include the face, legs, tail, and ears, remains a bit of a mystery. Matilda III, the regal ragdoll cat, was quite popular among the hotel guests until she passed away in 2017. She never missed a day at work as the difficulty of guest relations at the legendary Algonquin Hotel in New York, where she joyfully welcomed guests at the lobby. In October 2016, she was memorialized in hardcover in Matilda, the Algonquin cat which chronicled her fabulous life. R.I.P. Matilda.
If you've enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos. See you guys next time, goodbye!